we are going to do a full mix of a stoner rock song by only using the PSP Multiband plugin, so you really can hear what this plugin sounds like and what it can do. The Alltimer Multiband plugin is based on the well-known Alltimer plugin by PSP. As you could have known by the name, the Alltimer Multiband is not a single band compressor, but uses three bands for compression. All of these three bands can be set and tweaked independent from each other, and you select the frequency bands by changing the crossover bands in the plugin. I will explain all of the functions during the mix. Nice to know is that the plugin has been beta tested by people like Bob Olson and Bob Katz, and these are some good references. Before we start, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to this channel, a channel to help you out in recording, mixing and mastering. Let's go to the plugin. Here's the stoner rock song. It's the song Pusher Man by Dragneck. I have done a full breakdown of the recording, mixing and mastering of this song here. First, let's play the song without any processing happening.
You come to me with your deep red eyes, begging me for more. I must be some kind of god to you.
And here's the song with the Alltimer Multiband in its default setting, but I have adjusted the output a little bit because the Alltimer Multiband is already compressing a bit. As you can hear, it's already working. Let's start with drums. Here are the drums in solo. I want to make the bass drum thicker, the snare drum fatter with more snap, and I want to smoothen out the overheads and I want to slam the room microphones. Bass drum first. So I want to make the bass drum thicker. Let's play it. I'll do that by first setting the crossover for the low end with the crossover knob, and I want a natural blend of the low end, and I will set the order knob to second order setting. You have three choices: first order, second order and fourth order. The first order is 6 dB per octave and is the most smooth. The second order is 12 dB per octave. And the fourth order is 24 dB for the crossover point. And this is the most precise. Okay, let's play the bass drum again. Let's solo the low end. The attack will be set to slow because it's low and the release somewhere between a low and fast. 5 is fine. The ratio to 3:1, and I'll set the compress knob, which sets the threshold to nicely grab the low end. It's now doing about 4.5 dB of reduction, as you can see on the meter. The volume of the low end is now lower than without the compression. So let's compensate that by setting the output gain. Now the low end of the bass drum has more punch. Let's compress the attack of the kick to have less of a point but more of a wider splash. Let's first solo the band. I will set it to fastest attack, highest ratio for the compression, compression to max, and gain 2. Now I still have to need more gain, so I will raise the output gain of the entire plugin. And of course I need to lower the gain of the low band because that one is boosted now too. I have now worked with the high and low end, and that leaves the mid-range. This has the smack of the bass drum, and I will add some gentle compression and adjust the gain, so I will end up with a wet towel bass drum. Let's check it in a mix and do some final tweaks. Okay, that sounds nice. Snare drum is next. I'll do basically the same as with the bass drum, only I want more snap out of the snare. So I'll be checking crossover points, tweak the settings and check it in the mix. Let's check in the mix. You won't wake up until I want you to, 'cause I'm a wicked man. I like the snap, but I think a wider splash will be better in the mix anyway. I'll increase the tube emulation setting of the plugin to get more saturation on the snare. That pushes a bit better. Let's continue with overheads. I want them smoother and with more tail on the end of the crashes. I will only use the high and the middle band, so I will turn off the low band. And I will adjust the settings of the middle and the high band. Okay, let's quickly do the tom-toms. I will process them on the group bus and I will add saturation, attack and low end. Let's check it in the mix. The rooms are next up and I really want to slam them, but I don't want to multiband compress them, I just want everything compressed together. For that I turn off the high band and turn off the low band, which leaves the mid band. And as you can see, the crossover dials are now unavailable, which turns the multiband into a single band compressor. Very handy and it's a great bonus. I want the low end to be untreated, so I'll dial in the sidechain height pass filter over here. I will leave everything below 151 Hz untouched. Maybe it's a little bit too much and I will blend in some of the original signal, and I do that with the blend knob. That is better. Let's continue with vocal. Let's play a bit of the original. Do just a score, telling me that you'll do everything, but it's a loud rock vocal, it's a bit sibilant and it needs more high-end and lower mid-range presence. Let's first do something about the sibilance by using the high band as a subtle de-esser and also boost the high frequencies.
Must be some kind of god to you, the things you do just to score. I must be some kind of god to you, the things you do just to score. I must be some kind of god.
Okay, now we'll add some lower mid-range presence.
I must be some kind of god to you, the things you do just to score. God to you, the things you do just to score. I must be some kind of god to you, the things you do just to score.
I must be some kind of god to you, the things you do just to score. I must be some kind of god to you, the things you do just to score.
Now the vocal pushes better through in the mix. Let's continue with the bass guitar. Let's play a bit of the default settings. On the bass, let's compress the low ends, but not the sub bass. So we'll use the high pass sidechain, use the crossovers, and use a slow attack and a slower release to emulate an opto style compression. I also want the bass to have more presence, so I will set the mid-high crossover point to its lowest and compress the high band a lot. I will keep the mid-range more breathing, so little compression. I will play the bass in the mix and will use the gain of the mid band to bring the bass more forward in the mix. And what about the guitars? I will treat them once again as a group on the group bus. For this, I want to make sure the guitars leave room for the bass drum and the bass guitar, so the low end, the low band, will be reduced in volume, and I will concentrate on the mid band and high band for presence and aggressiveness. And now in the mix. I want the guitars to be a little bit wider, and for that I will use the width knob on the frequency bands. It's this one. With this one you can set the width to completely mids or sides. And this goes for all three bands. And since the width is independent for the three bands, you can also use it, for instance, for correcting phase issues in the low band, which is pretty nice. Okay, before I do the before and after comparison, so with and without the Oldtimer multiband plugins on all channels, let's go over the final few controls I did not mention yet. Here's the sidechain link knob, which sets the amount of channel linking of the control signal. And then we have the mode knob, which is pretty handy. Here we have this infinity sign, which means normal stereo linkage, but you can also do left, or just right, or just mid, or just the sides. So that has added flexibility. Here's the bypass knob. Here's the band link knob, which links all knobs of all bands together. It has the same function as with control, only this is permanent, and you can temporarily disable it by using control or command. And then we have a balance knob between the left and right channel, which is a panel of sorts. And here we have the valve emulation. It has an on and off switch, and you can set the amount of valve emulation. For more or less tube emulation. Okay, let's do the before and after comparison. First, I will play the track without the Oldtimer multiband plugin, and then I will play the track with the Oldtimer multiband plugin, and then I will do an A and B. Okay, let's start without the plugins. Let's turn the plugins on. And now I will turn them on and off. As you can hear, this plugin really does something good. It gives more oomph, it gives more presence, it sounds more mixed and is more fuller. And all of that with just the PSP Oldtimer multiband compressor. Thank you for watching. Did you already subscribe? I have plenty more review videos. Check them out in this playlist. Leave a comment and feel free to ask any question. See you next time. Bye.